Hello, Cornerstone Kids. I am so glad you are here with us at Cornerstone Kids Online. We have some great things planned. You will learn this month's theme and memory verse, sing a great worship song, and watch this week's true Bible story. At the end, you will have a chance to pray together as a family. But before we get started, let's review our Cornerstone Kids values. Number one, love God. We are created to pursue an authentic relationship with our Creator. Number two, love people. We exist every day to demonstrate God's love to a broken world. And number three, love life. We experience life to the fullest as we walk in our God-given identity. If you do each of these things each day, you can change not only your life, but the lives of others. Have a great week.
Lord, you are more powerful than the roar of the ocean. You are stronger than the waves of the sea. Psalm 93:4. Lord, you are more powerful than the roar of the ocean. You are stronger than the waves of the sea. Psalm 93:4.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because he said he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know.
Woo!
And when I'm feeling so sad.
Just follow me through.
Who?
Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Always got a Bible story for me and you.
Okay, Stormy Jane, you can come out of your doghouse now. I know it was hard to wait in there, but the rain has stopped and you can come out and play. Good girl. Oh, hi, friends. I'm Carrie the dog walker, and this is my best dog, Stormy Jane. I have a great story for you about someone who did something very hard. Are you ready? Okay, here we go. This is Joseph. Joseph trusted God's plan. Joseph worked at a big palace in Egypt for a man named Potiphar. Stormy Jane, you're not Potiphar. Get out of the story, silly dog. That's better. While Joseph worked at the palace, he tried to do a good job. If Potiphar told him to get food, Joseph got him food. If Potiphar said the floors needed sweeping, Joseph swept. Joseph did whatever Potiphar told him to do, and Joseph trusted God's plan for him. Then one day, somebody said Joseph did something very wrong, Everyone say, "Oh no! Oh no!" But Joseph didn't do it. Joseph was sent to jail anyway. Ugh, that would be very hard. Joseph didn't do anything wrong, but he was put in jail. Now at this point in the story, we might wonder if God really had a plan, because this was so hard for Joseph. But Joseph knew God loved him, and Joseph knew God was always with him. And so even though things were hard, Joseph trusted God's plan. Do you want to hear what Joseph did even though it was hard? Well, while he was in jail, Joseph helped the other people in there. The guards saw him doing such a good job, they even put him in charge. Joseph trusted God's plan, and God's plan for Joseph isn't done yet. There's a lot more of Joseph's story to tell. I love this story because it teaches us that we can trust God even when things are hard. Because God loves us, God's with us, and God's got a plan for us. Oh, hey, Ollie. Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.